Hey friends, welcome to Knack Graphics. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this 3D pawn. Let's start drawing this. First of all, turn off this Align Art to Pixel Grid button and make sure that the Smart Guides option is on. To make 3D pawn exactly like this, you will need help of some guides, and we will start with drawing these guides first. Pick Line Segment tool. Click once to open the dialog box. Here enter 300 for length and set the angle at 270 degrees. And here we get this vertical line. Now click on this anchor point to open the dialog box. Here enter 150 as length and set the angle to 0 degrees. Pick black arrow tool. Select these lines. Come to the view menu, guides, and choose make guides. Again come to view menu, guides, and choose lock guides. It will save the guides from any accidental selection while working. Okay, now pick ellipse tool and come here on the edge of this line. Press Alt key and click once to open the dialog box. Alt key is pressed to make a center outward circle. Here enter 120 for both width and height. Now come over this anchor point. Again press Alt key and click once to open the dialog box. This time enter 120 for width and 40 for height. Deselect this shape. Now pick pen tool and start drawing from this intersecting point to this point, and here drag out to give it a little curve like this. Click on this anchor point to make it a corner point. Now move straight to this point and come to this point to join the path like this. Press escape key to end drawing this segment. Pick black arrow tool and select this path. Pick reflect tool from here. Come over this anchor point. Press Alt key and click once to open the dialog box. Here select vertical and click copy. Alright, now pick rounded rectangle tool. Come here on this point. Press Alt key and click once to open the dialog box. Set width to 300, height to 60, and corner radius to 40. Now pick black arrow tool. Press down shift key and move this rounded rectangle upwards so that the base of this rectangle intersects with base of this shape like this. Okay, select all these shapes now. Come to the Pathfinder panel. If you don't have this panel docked here, come to window menu and you will get it here. Okay, here press this unite button to make one unified shape. Pick white arrow tool now and select this half of this shape like this and delete it. With this half selected, change the stroke color to this shade of brown. Now come to the effect menu, 3D, and pick revolve. Keep the default values of X, Y, and Z as such. Change the perspective angle to 45 degrees. Open more options. Change the light source at approximately this point and press OK. So the 3D pawn shape is ready. Now place it at this place. You will not need these guides again. So come to view menu, guides, and click on clear guides. Now let's draw its long shadow. This shape is selected. Copy it by pressing Ctrl C and press Ctrl F to paste it in front. Now the copy in front is selected. Come to object menu and go for expand appearance. With this selected, come to the Pathfinder panel and press this unite button. Change its fill color to this shade of gray. Now pick shear tool from here. Click here to make this point the reference point. Now drag this shape like this. I'm placing this shadow according to the light source we marked for the pawn shape. Yeah, it looks good here. Now right click on it. Here arrange and send this shadow shape to back. Keep it selected and change its opacity to 60%. Pick black arrow, select both these shapes and press Ctrl G to make it a group. So finally, let's draw a background for this. Pick rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Right click on it and send it to back. For its fill color, come to the gradient panel. Click here to fill the default gradient. Set the gradient type to radial. Double click this color slider and pick this shade of brown color for it. Zoom out a bit. Pick gradient tool and drag the gradient from here like this. Adjust the oval shape like this. And here we are. The design is ready. I hope you liked this tutorial. Express your views by hitting like button or writing in the comment section below. And do subscribe for upcoming tutorials. Goodbye for now.